Hello friends, it's me again, Nike at DME, just coming your way to help someone in their life's journey, just to encourage someone. Yes, there's so much to learn, there's so much to know, and what is important to act on the things that we know so far. There's no point just storing up knowledge, storing up information, you know, saying, oh Lord, I want to hear from you. I want to hear from you. I want to know what you are saying. Have we acted on what he has said? Did you act on the last instruction and you're wanting more? You know, and sometimes we, you know, amass so much information and so much, you know, knowledge and all these things that we know might just, I don't know, bring us to a point of big-headedness. Like, we know all these things, but how much of it are we acting on? And he says that it's the doer of the word that is blessed. So I just want to encourage us today to think deeply, and how much of the word of God am I doing? How much of his instructions have I obeyed, you know, before going on to the next thing that we think, you know, he's saying or he's doing in the earth? Sometimes we just need to obey the simple things, and he would have pleasure in us, and we ourselves will be confident that we are on the right path. It's so important to be doers of the word, to have the right intention, to have the right motive. And what's the motive for all things? Love. He says, if I have faith that I could move mountains, and you know, if I do not have love, I'm nothing. And may we not be nothing. We are not nothing. But what he's trying to say is that it profits me nothing. It doesn't bring any profit. It doesn't bring any reward when we do things out of selfish motives, when we do things, you know, just out of the total wrong motive, when we do things in a way that will grieve God. One of the things we need to pay attention to is what the gifts we have been given and what we have been called to do. What's your primary assignment? What is my primary assignment? What do you feel the Lord impressing on your heart? And even in the little things, you know, showing respect for one another, he says love is not rude, love is kind, love does not parade itself, it's not puffed up, it doesn't think evil, love does not rejoice at evil or iniquity. Love hopes all things and believes all things. So I want to encourage us to be hopeful, to look on the positive side of things and pay attention to what assignments we have been given, whatever we have been told to do. I know that one of my gifts is mercy, compassion. That's what God has given me to do. I'm almost always thinking about girls on the streets, prostitutes, children who are homeless, until God gave me an idea many, many years ago just to have my own orphanage, to have a shelter for young ladies. That brought some relief, that brought some, you know, not total comfort, but at least that gave me some sense of the fact that I am obeying, I am doing what I am called to do. You know, and even now they give me joy. I think about the girls in the shelter, I think about the children in the orphanage, and I feel I'm on my assignment. But that's not the end of it. Every day we need to be sensitive and say, what more, Lord? Even within this assignment, what am I to do? How am I to handle this situation? You know, there's so much to do, rather than just going around, you know, going on what's the next thing happening in town. You know, focus on what you've been told to do. Obey and you will have awesome results. It says, if you are willing and obedient, you will eat the good of the land. And I see you eating the good of the land. I see you being productive. I see you, you know, having wealth. I see you having enough to take care of yourself and others. Rewards of obedience are coming your way. Friends, that's all I have for you. Till I come your way next time, keep shining, keep loving, keep being your best. Bless you.